Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our lesson, that is life processes. And we have seen various topics in that lesson: photosynthesis, factors affecting photosynthesis, the nutrition in amoeba, the term is phagocytosis. And today is the last session of the digestive system, human digestive system. I explain you human digestive system along with its gland properly in detail. Okay, and in last session I had explained you about small intestine and the stomach. We had a closer look on all those points. Okay, what are the related with the small intestine? Now I would not repeat all of them. You can go back and see properly. And whenever you will see that those properly, those videos and those parts properly, then only you will be able to understand today's session. So let's start without wasting our time. Let's start today's topic, that is large intestine. Okay, so we are looking for the large intestine in today's topic. If we will talk about the large intestine, then no digestion is taking place into the large intestine. Whatever the part of there of digestion and absorption was completed already into the small intestine. Then what exactly happens into the large intestine? See, students, there is one term, excretion and defecation. Most of us are quite confused about excretion and the defecation. Defecation means whatever the solid excreta is accumulated in our body. Periodically, when we get rid of that solid excreta through our body, through a specific organ called as an anus, is called as defecation technique. That is not termed as a excretion. Excretion means the nitrogenous waste which is accumulated in our body in the form of urea and uric acid. The removal of that nitrogenous waste from the body by the proper excretory system or by the urinary system is called as excretion. So please do not misunderstand and do not confuse in these two terms. Excretion, defecation is not the part of the excretion. Yes, that is the waste material of our body, solid waste material of our body, and we are getting rid of it, no doubt, no problem in that. But these two terms are absolutely different. Okay, so this was the first point that I wanted to let you know all, and so that I have told you. Now let me start with my large intestine. Large intestine, I said you, there is no digestion is taking place. Okay, this is the last part of the digestive system, human digestive system. See, if we will see the digestive system, then large intestine is designed in this manner. What it is called, as you will go in your higher classes, you will be knowing in detail about it. This part which I am drawing it is called as a fostra. This part is called as what? Fostra. But here in class 10, you are not going to study about this fostra part. But as I am drawing over here, you should know what it is. So this part is called as what? Fostra. This part, the swollen part or the pouch-like structure is present. That part is called as a fostra. That you will learn in class 11 into the human physiology, means digestive system. The physiology, you will be able to learn it properly. Okay, and inside it, I said you, there is a coil-like structure, that is the small intestine, okay? That I have already let you know in yesterday's session, so I will not have a more focus on it. Now, I shall go ahead. I told you the last part of the small intestine is what? Ileum. Okay, I said you the last part of the small intestine is what? Ileum. And for your better understanding, here I have attached one picture, so you can see that if you are confused in it. So this part which is attached, this last part of the small intestine is what? Ileum. Okay, last part of the small intestine is ileum, and this part will open into the first part of the digestive system, that is called as what? Cecum. That is called as what? Cecum. Or this is also called as a cecum. That is the difference only in the Latin and the British English. That's it. Okay. So this part is what? Which is joined from the small intestine to the large intestine. Here, student, valve is present. See, about valve, you will be knowing in detail in our circulatory system. Whenever we are going to study about the heart, at that time you will be knowing in detail about the valve. But here you should know what this structure is exactly present. This structure is called as a ileocecal valve. Valve is present. And the function of the valve is whatever the food material, whatever the undigested part of the food, because the food has already digested and absorbed nutrients by the small intestine, but whatever the part which is still in the solid part, we can say, which is undigested part, or the digestive system is unable to digest it, that part will transfer from ileum to the large intestine through this valve that is called as a ileocecal valve. This valve ensures the re-entry of the food material, backflow it is avoided. Okay, means once it will enter into the cecum, this is the last part, or this is the first part of the large intestine called as a cecum, right? When the food is entering into the cecum, which is the first part of the large intestine, then that food will not be able to return back into the ileum, and for that sake this ileocecal valve is designed. I hope you understand this concept, what is the function of this ileocecal valve. Okay, and here the pouch like structure is present, that is called as what? Cecum, I said you just now. Okay, which is the smallest part of the large intestine. After it, the part is started. This part is called as what? Colon. Actually, the longest part of the large intestine is colon only, and the smallest part of the large intestine is cecum. Okay, so this is what? Colon. But here three types of the food, the undigested particle, we will say now, undigested part of the food will travel from this cecum to the colon, and this part is called as what? Ascending colon. This part is called as what? Ascending colon. Okay, after it the path is transverse in the transverse direction, or the straight line path. So this is called as what? Transverse colon. Okay, after it, undigested particle of the food will be coming down, so that this part of the colon is called as descending colon. Okay, after the descending colon, the colon has not yet finished. Still the structure of colon is there, and the structure is like a sigma or S shape. So this part of the colon is called as what? Sigmoid colon. I hope the colon part is clear for you. Ascending colon, the food particles which are undigested will now enter into the ascending colon, and they will be moving into the upward direction. Right? After moving into the upward direction, as they will reach at the top, they will be moving in a straight line direction. And so that this part of the colon is called as what? Transverse colon. After transverse colon, again they will be coming down into the downward direction. The undigested particles of the food will be coming down, and so that part of the colon will be said as a descending colon. Okay, after it will be reaching to the sigmoid colon. This is just the pathway of the colon. Okay, sigmoid colon. There is no specific reason behind the name of the sigmoid colon. Because of just the shape, then sigmoid name is given. After the sigmoid colon, there is one tract, or we can say this part is called as rectum. This part is called as what? Rectum. Temporarily, please keep in mind, temporarily the undigested food particles, now undigested particle is now, it is said to be fecal matter. What it is called as? Fecus, or the fecal matter. okay? Or probably or simply in our day-to-day life, we use the word stool, okay? That we pass periodically through anus, that is called as what? Fecal matter. So temporarily, this fecal matter is stored into the rectum, okay? And at the bottom of the rectum, there is small opening to go out this fecal matter called as an anus. But before each, the specific time, as I said, you throughout our whole alimentary canal, there are sphincter muscles are present, right? Every part, near to the every part, it regulates the entry and exit. So here what happens? The anal sphincter muscles are present. Okay, anal sphincter muscles are actually voluntary muscles. Voluntary muscles means this is in our hand to control the passing of the fecal material. But if the deposition of the fecal matter will be more, then those voluntary muscle turns into involuntary, okay, and the fecal matter may come out. So we cannot bear extra pressure of it, and we should not actually, because this is the waste material of the body, and time to time we must get rid of it. So rectum accumulates or stores the fecal matter temporarily until we do not get rid of it, and at the end of it we have a small opening called as an anus, okay? That is called as a anus, okay? So this is all about what the structures and the parts of the large intestine. Now we will be talking about what is the function exactly, what is taking place over here. I said you just the undigested particles are moving from one part to the other part. But exactly what is happening here? That I shall let you know now. Okay, so whenever the undigested particles are entering from the ileum through ileocecal wall into the cecum, that time it contains actually 1.5 to 2 kg of the undigested food particles. See a student, 1.5 to 2 kg, this much excretory material is still present. But we have a symbiotic organisms over here. Symbiotic organisms are present over here, and the name of that symbiotic organism which is present in this cecum, that is called as a E. coli bacteria. The name of that is what? E. coli bacteria. What this E. coli bacteria is doing and why it is called as a symbiotic microorganism or organism? Symbiosis, you might be knowing. In symbiotic relationship, both the organisms are benefited by giving and taking relationship. Okay, both are living in a harmony, both are giving and taking and living in a harmony. We have a very good example of a lichen. Since lower grades you are learning about this symbiotic relationship, I shall not go in detail. Now we will have a closer look on the cecum, which contains the E. coli bacteria or the E. coli microorganisms. Okay. And these organisms are actually symbiotic because they are helping us to reduce the bulk of our waste material. Means what? Whatever the undigested particles are coming into the cecum, still it contains some nutrients, student. Still, it is not without nutrients. Still, some amount of carbohydrates or glucose, whatever we can say. Some amount of nutrients are still present in it, and those nutrients are getting utilized for the growth and proper functioning of the body by the E. coli bacteria. Understood, students? And at the same time, as they are using our waste material as their food, we are going to reduce the bulk of the waste material. Means our waste material was before 1.5 to 2 kg. But now it is reduced only to 150 gram. Okay. Throughout the day, we pass the fecal matter, that is of 150 gram only, not more than that. Actually, it is 1.5 to 2 kg. But as because of this E. coli bacteria have used that nutrition, so it is turned out to be only 150 gram. Okay. So after using by the E. coli bacteria, that undigested particle is still moving into the upward direction. Then now what is exactly taking place here into the ascending colon, transverse colon and the descending colon? Here also the absorption, still some particles, still some nutrients, still some vitamins, still some minerals are present into that undigested food particles, and if they will go out from the body along with the fecal matter, then it will go in vain. So our body is in need of that. So here also the absorption will be the major event. Absorption of all those nutrients will be taking place. What will get absorbed over here? Vitamin K. Students, vitamin K helps in the clotting of the blood, which is very very important for the clotting of the blood. So what is going to be happen over here? So vitamin K is responsible for the clotting of the blood, right? So vitamin K will get absorbed here, as well as some amount of electrolytes, means some minerals and some vitamins, some nutrients will get absorbed by this wall of the large intestine, especially into the colon, ascending colon, transverse colon and the descending colon. The major absorption will be taking place into the transverse colon. Okay, and everywhere throughout the large intestine, the peristaltic movement is only taking place. But the fast peristaltic movement is taking place into the rectum. So what will happen from the cecum, from the ascending colon? The absorption of the vitamins, absorption of the nutrients, absorption of the minerals, absorption of the electrolyte will be taking place. And whatever after it, that after absorbing the water, water also will get absorbed. Water will be also the major thing which is not present into the fecal matter or the stool of the human being. So that will also get absorbed. And as the water, all the nutrients will get absorbed, it will turn into the solid. So solidification of the undigested food particle will be taking place over here. And through this passage, through the sigmoid colon, through rectum and through anus, the body will get rid of these particles. Okay, so here one important point which I have not yet forgot, but I wanted to let you know. Here we have vermiform appendix. We have one structure which look like a worm, so it is called as what? Vermiform appendix. It is called what? Vermiform appendix. As I said you, I think whenever I let you know about the alimentary canal, I said you the early man was used to eat the cellulose rich food, uncooked raw food the early man was using to eat. Okay, for the survival, early man was using food as a raw, which was raw flesh, everything was raw. And so that what happens, the specific kind of enzymes were secreting into the body of the early man. Okay, so this appendix was the functional, this part, vermiform appendix was the functional part into the early man. But later on, there was a discovery of the cooked food, there was a discovery of the farming practices. And so that what happens, the early man started eating cooked food. So that this part, appendix, vermiform appendix, this part becomes non-functional. And slowly, nowadays students, you might not be knowing, nowadays whatever the children are taking birth, some children do not have this part also. Kahi kahi mulangmadhe ha part nasto halli. So this part is not present in some children now, because this is the non-functional part. Because we started eating the cooked food, soft food, so this part is not needed. So this part is called as a vestigial organ of the body, that we shall learn in heredity and the evolution. So I hope you understand about the large intestine everything. So here I am very glad to say you that very successfully we have completed human digestive system along with the digestive gland. And now we shall start. As the food has digested, students, it's interesting, whatever the material, whatever the food nutrient we have digested, that nutrients have passed from the villi. Okay, passed from the blood vessels. Now they have reached into our blood, and from the blood, wherever it is needed, it will go. But what happened exactly to that food? What happened to that nutrient? That we will be learning into the respiration, human respiratory system, or the respiration we are going to learn. That is also going to be quite interesting. Thank you so much.